Howdy, Possum Patty here. And yepers, we had some wintry weather. We had 4 or 5 inches of snow, but then it turned to sleet and freezing rain, and then a little bit of melting, and now everything is freezing again. So it's a bit of a mess out there, but I've got my snuggly fleece on and I'm cozy inside, but we're having some technical difficulties. Yes, we are. I got out my paints. I got out toys to make texture because we're going to scrape paint and put painty backgrounds on our zines that we made yesterday. And the fairies are busy working back there. So I was prepping everything and the lights went out. I thought it was an electrical outage. I'm thinking the ice on the branches is going to bring them down on electric wires and knock out the power. And I shrugged my shoulders, went out to the other room to get a lantern, and the electricity was on in the other room. So I went back there. Mr. Possum was in his computer room, and his power was out. So the only power out in the house are these two rooms here, the studio and the computer room. And we're thinking, oh, maybe it's a breaker. Go downstairs and flip those breakers, Mr. Possum. So he went down the basement to flip those breakers. No luck. No electricity in the studio. So he called the electrician, and they think it is like one of the ground fault plugs because we had problems with another one in the other room, and everything kept shutting off. So, yeah, so Mr. Possum coming out of the basement now. So I've got a couple little lights here. And I can't get to my journaling. Maybe tomorrow, hopefully, we'll get it fixed. We'll go out. Hopefully, the roads will be so icy. Get out and get some parts and get that fixed tomorrow. I got all this stuff out to scrape paint. And I really want to have some painty play. So I might do just a little bit tonight. Clean some of this up, and then tomorrow hopefully we'll get the lights back on and I'll get my journaling done. So just a quick little play tonight. And I see these fairies over here have been busy making journals, and I'll share that with you. And the fairies back there, they're busy scraping paint, which is what I want to get to. So come on along. Well, if you're saying, Possum Patty, I'm not an artist, I cannot make painty papers, then this is the video for you. Because making painty paper backgrounds is super easy, super fun, and very satisfying. Anybody can do it. Get the kids, they can do it. You can do it, they can do it, anybody can do it. Very simple supplies. Very easy technique, very satisfying result. Now, I have a couple of extra things here that you don't need, but I'm going to show you what I have and what I'm going to do. First thing you're going to need are some paints. Now, I have a mix of some real artist acrylic colors by Liquitex and some Blick store brand studio acrylics. Usually anything studio is not as expensive as artist. And I have some very cheap acrylics and just quite a mixture here. So whatever kind of acrylic paint you have, you might have, let me reach down here. You might have some craft paint, and this is fine, but you have to remember it's usually more liquidy than the kind that comes in a tube, and you might have to compensate for that, but still usable. And this is just, you know, like what you get at the Dollar Tree for $1.25. So any kind of acrylic paint is going to work. You might have some of those little bottles like you get at Walmart. Yeah,
I got one out here. Something like this. These work fine too. This is probably a little thicker than the kind you get at the Dollar Tree. Any kind of acrylic paints here. I got heavy body, got regular, got Dollar Tree, got Walmart. Any kind of acrylic paint. And so if you're not an artist and you're not sure about, you know, investing in this technique, just buy some cheaper paints. You know, these are very inexpensive. And get the craft paint, because then you could always use it for something else. Now you need something to cover the table. I will get paint everywhere. I've just got these old brochure pages here. Let me make some room. You need something to scrape with. No, any kind of old gift card that you have, any kind of plastic card that's no good anymore, or you can go to the Dollar Tree and buy a scraper. And to tell you the truth, I'd rather use the card than the scraper. Or you might even have a palette knife. I do have one here somewhere. Palette knife. And this is a knife that the artists use, called a palette knife. And all it does is spread the paint around, right? Some artists even paint with a palette knife, right? They go right on the canvas with the palette knife and lay their colors down. So this is a palette knife. And you need, something to put your paint on, right? Now I'm using a gel plate. And this is a special plate that artists use for printing. I'm looking for the cover of the gel plate. I found some more book pages though. I found something. So this is Jelly Art's gel plate, and it's what artists use to make mono prints. They roll out their ink or their paint, and then they make textures or designs, and they press their paper on it, and they make a print. You don't need this. It's just what I'm using right now, a surface. I mean, if you have a piece of packaging that's plastic, you can use this. This is perfect. Use the packaging of something. Doesn't matter. You might have one of those silicone art mats and you could do it right on there. If you don't have anything like a piece of parchment paper or wax paper or anything like that. All right, so, and then you need paper. And I am just using some book paper. Some pages from, these look like they're from different books because they're different colors. But you can use any kind of paper that you want to. Now, specifically, we're working on the zine. And if you're going to make a zine, you'll have to watch yesterday's videos about making the zine. You can make it painty before you split it and fold it and do all that. But since yesterday we learned how to make the zine, it's already folded and cut. So we're just going to decorate it right now. Well, so I don't wind up with a bunch of mud, I like to start maybe with a few lighter colors and save like the white and the black or a darker color to do the printing mark making on top. And I've got a little bit of this yellow left. I think the fairies were using this. I think they left me a little. Now these blicks, this was a gift several years back. And it's like sample colors, and you get like 50 of them in a box to try it out. And just squeeze it down on your surface. Okay, so you have your paint on something. You have your paper. You have your scraper. Put a little bit of that paint on your scraper like that. And scrape. Easy peasy pumpkin squeezy. What a nice bright yellow. Now you're not painting this side of the garage. So it's kind of cool to leave white spaces, especially when you have something patterned like a book page. And you can kind of see that right through there. You won't see as much when I'm done, but I'm only going to make a couple of these, like I said, because I've got extension cords running and it's a little dark in here. All right, so I got some yellow on there. And it usually dries pretty quick because you're scraping it thin. It's still going to be wet. Don't worry about filling in all the spaces, though. Oh, there's some blue on here. That's right. I was already squeezing out paint. Mr. Possum says, what are you doing in there with the extension cords? I said, well, I was putting paint out and the lights went out and I've got to get in here and finish this. Okay. I said, what am I going to do? I already started. Well, where there's a will, there's a way, right? Oop. This is dry. I'd love to use up some of this old paint. Let me grab a napkin. There's one. Okay, now in pink, some little samples. Now I've got some paint on the card. Now I can take another paper. And wipe that off if I don't want to put any more in there. You don't want to wipe it with a napkin and waste it. Just get another piece of scrap paper and go ahead and wipe that right on there. And I'm going to put some pink on top of this. Oh, these are the three colors that the fairy started with, but you know what? I think we'll try something different. I don't know if this is still good. Somebody gifted me a whole bunch of these crafty colors. You see how this one's very liquidy. Very liquidy. Did I just get that on there? I did. I am so good at making messes. Oh, I see. It came through the back. See, with that split in the middle, you got to be careful. Okay. Of course, now I just flipped it over, right? Sometimes I wind up loving the clean-off sheet better than what I'm working on. Oh, yeah. Okay. I didn't want mine to look like the... too much like the fairies paper because, yeah, I wanted this one to be a little different. Wow, that's like fluorescent orange there. Very cool, though. Getting a 60s vibe going here. Now I'm going to let this one dry for a few minutes. And while that one's drying, just play with another one. Got all this orange. Now orange and blue are complementary on the color wheel. So when you put them together, you're going to get a neutral color. But that blue's just about dry, so they're not really mixing too much. See, that orange and blue is making like a gray tone in there. Let's use this all up. All right, now let's play with some texture. So on this one, all I've done so far is use this card to scrape paint. So let's try a couple other different ways of doing it. I have this piece of corrugated cardboard that I'm dipping into the paint and just pressing down on the paper. I'm getting paint on my sleeves. I'll wash it off after. I guess I need to make myself an apron. This will look really good over something that's already been painted. Another thing to do is use like a toilet roll. So you have corrugated cardboard, a toilet roll. Let's try this. I want a lighter color. There's a yellow. There's some yellow in here. If you have a blob of paint on here you don't necessarily want, just take it off and scrape it on another paper. We're going to come back to the zine in just a minute. Still kind of wet. Put the final touches on that. And you could also print right off the plate or whatever you're using. Don't waste any of the paint. Well, let's check on the fairies in the fairy corner. Now, as you can see, the fairy lights don't need electricity. They're all lit up. It might be a little dark for our eyes, but they can see just fine. And they are painting their zines, making painty paper background for their zine. And there's two of them finished. They're down here drying on the table. And it looks like they're all working on one, because when you unfold it, it sort of takes up the whole table, huh? Yeah. All right, let's check out their supplies. They have some acrylic paint on a little piece of plastic. They have little plastic cards, and they just dip it in the paint and scrape a little bit. And then they scrape it on the paper. And Maggie Rose is holding Punchinella. And they scrape the paint through the Punchinella and do some mark making and patterns on top of the painty background. Now it looks like they used yellow, pink, and blue, and then did mark making with black and a little bit of white. I love that combo, ladies. Oh, and I love the combo of the paint on your aprons. Well, I'm so happy we made aprons yesterday, so you didn't get your frocks all painty. Well, I'm going to let them go back. It looks like they're almost done there. They have two drying on the table, like I said, and the third one looks like it's almost finished. I've never tried this, but I watched somebody, they put paint on the cardboard and then scrape that way. All right, let's see how this goes. Oh, well, that's fun. Yes, that is. But see, I got some left on there. I don't want to waste that. That's got to come off anyway. I love that. I love that. What do you think? Put the paint right. Oh, let's do one more. All right. I've got to do one more before I move on. Put these down. All right. I had this color. Putting the paint. Oops. Trying to put the paint close to the edge. That's a lot of paint. All right, it'll be fine. And then I had pink. Well, let's put yellow. Yellow next to the blue. And then pink. And then orange. Ooh.
Oh, no.
Oops. Oops. All right, which is too watery. Put that over there. All right, I don't want to waste it, so we're gonna go with it. We're gonna go with it. Let's see. I'm loving this. I'm loving this. Look at this. I started off doing one thing, now I'm doing something else, but oh my gosh. I love this. I love this. Look at that. A new way to scrape paint. I know it's not a new way. A new way for me to scrape paint. Oh my goodness. I love that. I love that. All right, let's get back to what we were doing. Okay. So then I want to do a dark color on top to do some mark making. I've got silver. I got burnt umber. Burnt umber. Is there any in here? I was just going to say some of these tubes need to get thrown out, but I want to use it to the very last drop. Okay, I've got this, which is like a styrofoam from the bottom of, like when you buy chicken, I guess, at the grocery store. Looks like a waffle. I should probably try it on another piece of paper since that's my zine. Well, I'm not impressed with this, although it is getting better. Okay, if I roll it a little bit, I can get like a little waffle print on there. Yeah, that's good. I think the brown looks nice with all this orange. All right, I don't want to do too much of the same because I want to do something different. So I'm going to use this toilet paper roll. This is so satisfying to just sit here and have painty paper play, let me tell you. Once you start, it's like, oh, let me do more, let me do more. Same thing with gel plate printing and painty paper fun. You just want to keep going and going. And let's see, for the white, could I use yellow? Instead of black and white, do brown and yellow. Do brown and yellow. Okay, my gel plate needs to get cleaned off. Big blob of brown there. I also have a composition cheap book from the Dollar Tree that I clean things off in. Oh, this is dry down here, so I gotta clean it off. Okay, let's see if this yellow will show up. Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, for change, instead of black and white, I'm using the yellow and the brown. You know, and you learn by experimenting. You learn by playing. You know, this is how children learn. They learn by playing. And this is how artists learn. They learn by playing. So I learned about scraping, putting the paint on the cardboard and scraping. I love that. I love that. Let me know if you've tried that. You know, because sometimes I feel like I live under a rock and everybody's tried it but me. Look how gorgeous this came out. Look at this. I'm loving this color combination. And when it's dry, I'm going to fold it up just like this. Oh, and look at the cover. Oh my gosh. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. All right, don't do that until it's dry. I'm going to let it dry. I'm going to wash my hands, and I'm going to come back and answer your question, because I know there's three of you out there shouting right now, okay, Possum Patty, we've made our zine, we've painted it, it's dry, we've got it all folded up nice together, now what? I'll answer that question in just a moment. Okay, you've made your zine, now what? Well, you can use your zine for anything you want to. I know that doesn't answer your question, but I'm looking over there at Lulu Ladybug and Little Pixie, and they've already made some zines, and they want to share those zines with you. Now, while the other fairies were busy scraping paint and playing away, they took the zine that I made yesterday out of painty paper. And because it was already made and the paper was already painted, they could spend their whole time just filling up their zines. Now, I'm looking at this and I'm laughing because the zine was this size and it looks like they just chopped it in half to make two smaller zines instead of one larger one. And that's okay if they needed to make it a little smaller so, you know, they were able to work in it. No problem. And they're telling me they had two ideas for the zine, so that's why they cut it. Oh, okay. I'm corrected. I stand corrected. They cut it in half because they had two ideas for the zines, and they decided that they wanted to do both. Now, this one, Lulu Ladybug is telling me, it's not quite finished, but it's going to be a glue book. It's going to be a rainbow glue book. And on each page, she's going to have one color of the rainbow in order of the rainbow. So we have red and orange and yellow and green and blue and purple, and the back is for black and white. I don't know, it looks pretty finished to me. Oh, she said she wants to put a ladybug on the cover, and she has a little tiny space here and there that if she finds a small enough image, you know, maybe she will add it to there, like, you know, a couple of little areas here where she can add something to it. So Lulu Ladybug has used her zine to make a glue book, and she's doing a rainbow glue book with black and white on the back. All right, that's very interesting. That's one idea. Thank you for sharing, Lulu. Well, Little Pixie has made a very special journal. She learned a new word the other day, and that word is glimmers. Now, glimmers, she says, are small moments that spark joy. Oh, she's telling me she heard one of the possum peeps talking about this. Glimmers. And, oh, yeah, she made the page all glimmery. Look at that. It sparkles and glimmers. And she's thinking of small moments that spark joy. So any little moment that brings you joy is a glimmer. Nothing big, just small little things. And on the cover, she has a fairy with her bathing suit on, and she's getting ready to plunge into the pond. Well, that's certainly a lot of fun, isn't it? Just that moment of hitting the water. And what else is in here? Ooh, cake. Definitely a moment of joy right there, right? A party without cake is just a meeting. Yes, that's making me giggles, and giggles with friends. That's definitely a glimmer. Giggles with friends, yes. Creating is joy, and she's got a sketchbook here. Oh, that is super fun. Creating is joy. And on the back, it says, follow your heart. That's kind of like, do what makes your heart happy. And that's Janet Nash's saying for 2024. Pixie's reminding me that this one has pockets. Okay. So in the first pocket, there's a sunshine. And it says, look on the bright side. Well, of course, being out on a sunny day is a glimmer for sure. And everyone around here is waiting for that particular glimmer with all the dark, rainy, and snowy weather that we've had. Here's another pocket. And this one has stars on it. And this one says, under the wide and starry sky. So going out at night when there's a clear sky and looking up and gazing at the stars, that is a glimmer. And here's another pocket. This one has a butterfly with some daisies. And this one says, don't forget to fly. Well, I'm not a fairy, but I'm sure Pixie and Lulu Ladybug love to fly. But you know what? Even if you're not a fairy and you don't have wings, there's other meanings to the word fly, right? Because we can soar as much as we want to. And soaring is just doing what we love to do and being happy. And there's one more down here. Oh, and this has a forest with some deer. And it says explore. And of course, exploring in nature is a glimmer. Pixie's, she's a little wild thing. She loves to be outside exploring nature. And let me tell you, I do too. I love to explore outside. Well, Pixie, this really is a special Glimmers journal. So there are two ideas on what to do with your zine. You can turn it into a glue book. You can turn it into a collection of special things or collages or journaling, whatever you want to. And I know they're tiny. Yours doesn't have to be this small, right? Because this one is going to be, you know, a bit bigger. But you know what? I can fill this out and I can stick this into a pocket in my journal and I can pull it out and have all kinds of wondrous things inside to look at. This really makes your journaling page interactive. Don't try doing anything till it's dry. My hands are ready from picking this stuff up. Just give it some time to dry. Sit back, relax, let it sit overnight, and then get to it. No rush. But I'm going to rush back and do some more paint scraping. This was absolutely my fave over here. I put on the cardboard and I just had a play. Well, I better get going. And I don't want Mr. Possum tripping over that cord that's out in the hallway. So thanks for coming along today. So happy I can make a little bit of a video, even with these technical difficulties. Hope it wasn't too dark for you. I just want to wish everybody happy painty play. Bye-bye now.